This investigation will look at polarized light and the effect of polarizers on light. So you'll need a light source. You can use a small LED or a desk lamp, whichever your TA has set up for you. If you're using the LED, power it with a Hamden and only go up to 3 volts. So you'll see the LED just come on and then get bright. You don't have to go any higher than that. Once the LED is on, you can take some of your polarizers and just investigate what happens to the light through those filters as you rotate one filter with respect to the other. And so you should be able to extinguish or nearly extinguish the light and then barely attenuate it more than just one filter. To help you get a little more precise, we have an optical bench with some holders, and so you can put one filter in your first of 3 holders and your other in the 3rd of 3 holders. We'll save that middle holder for future experiments in just a moment. There we have the light not being much attenuated compared to this orientation of the filter, where we instead see much more attenuation of the light. Now I have a 3rd filter, and if I put it on this side, no matter what angle I turn it to, it doesn't have an effect. Similarly, if I put it in between the light and my holder, but if I put it in the middle, I'm taking something that's dark, adding it to something that's dark, and getting something that's light, and that's what we want you to investigate. So you can look at the different angles there. How much of an angle do I have to turn through to go from completely dark to completely dark compared to turning this one? How much do I have to rotate through to go from completely dark to completely dark again? And again, this is where that 3rd holder comes in if you want to be more systematic and have your hands free as you're investigating and writing. You can put that one in that 3rd holder and look for where is that dark, and then how much do you have to turn it to go to light, and then how much do you have to turn it to get back to dark.